Formula One may have been absent from Mexico for 23 years, but after 2015's triumphant return, it was as if we'd never been away. In Mexico, a Grand Prix is more than just a race. It's a celebration of speed and of bravery. There's nothing quite like the atmosphere in the stadium today. They'll be drowning out the cars with their noise as they make their way through on lap one. The Autódromo Hermanos Rodríguez, 2.6 miles of track that allows drivers to take full advantage of their cars, reaching speeds in excess of 220 miles per hour and providing lots of opportunities for overtaking. The circuit features 17 corners, 10 to the right and the remaining 7 going to the left. And it's an absolute pleasure to be joined once again by Anthony Davidson. Why don't we start by talking about Carlos Sainz? As ever, the threat of unreliability is never far away, and indeed they'll be starting out of position today due to a power unit component change. So it's going to be a difficult task to move forward from there.
But on the bright side, at least those fresh components can help them maintain the power they need to come through the pack. I expect to see them take a more aggressive approach today to make up for the compromised start.
It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. It's McLaren in pole position then. Sergio Perez lines up alongside. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Weber, Norris, Pierre Gasly, and Stroll, Bottas, Albon, Kvyat, and Charles Leclerc, Vettel, Hülkenberg, Daniel Ricciardo, and Magnussen, Verstappen, Russell, Robert Kubica, and Lewis Hamilton. Butler and Carlos Sainz will start from the back of the grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Okay, the run into turn one isn't too long, so the pack will be bunched up. Take care. Okay, our system checks are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of the lap. Threat of rain for the time being. Conditions looking good. The rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. We're looking good from the start. Lap of the race so far. There's 15 laps of fuel remaining. By a few seconds per lap. Keep this up. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Okay, copy that. No? You're pitting this lap then? Come into the pits at the end of this lap. Exit now. Pit strategy complete. See these tires through to the end now. Nico is in for his stop. Virtual safety car deployed. Slow down and maintain a positive delta. Virtual safety car is deployed. Okay, some information on signs. They've got a serious car issue. It looks like they're retiring. Positive delta until the green flags. Green flag. Yellow flag. Thank you. Okay, you're creating some breathing space between you and the car behind by a few seconds per lap. Laps of fuel remaining. Three laps of fuel remaining. You're increasing the gap to the car behind by a few seconds per lap. Keep this up. There's only one lap of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. Your 18th consecutive win of the season. You are making history this year. You should be very proud of today's result. Congratulations.
What a fantastic Grand Prix that was, and an excellent win for McLaren. What do you think it was, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition today?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
Our winning drivers are on their way to the podium right now. It's been a fantastic race for McLaren, that's for sure, and no doubt they'll be celebrating tonight. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
It's got to